Come, let's share in the banquet of the Lord, in the blessed sacrament. Come, let's share in the supper of the Lord, in the blessed sacrament. Eat the bread and drink the wine, flesh and blood of the Lord divine. Share His life, it is yours and mine, for we are one in His design. Come, let's share in the passion of the Lord, in the blessed sacrament. Come, let's share the resurrection of the Lord, in the blessed sacrament. Eat the bread and drink the wine, flesh and blood of the Lord divine. Share His life, it is yours and mine, for we are one in His design. Eat the bread and drink the wine, flesh and blood of the Lord divine. Share His life, it is yours and mine, for we are one in His design.
This Mass is offered for the soul of Stephen Lino Cordera, first anniversary, soul of Senen Gonzalez, first anniversary, soul of Douglas Lobo, first anniversary, and for various box intentions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit. Welcome to the third day of our Navina in honor of Saint Anthony. Our overall theme is the Holy Family, a model for all families. Today, we celebrate the solemnity of the body and blood of Christ. In the Eucharist, Jesus offers Himself to us out of love for us. Jesus uses the occasion of a meal to help us realize His presence with us always. A meal unites people, holds and sustains a family together, and builds community. In the words of Amoris Laetitia, Jesus knocks on the door of families to share with them the Eucharistic supper.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world. On us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. For live and reign with God the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, Moses came and told the people all the words of the Lord and all the rules. And all the people answered with one voice and said, "All the words that the Lord has spoken, we will do." And Moses wrote down all the words of the Lord. He rose early in the morning and built an altar at the foot of the mountain and 12 pillars, according to the 12 tribes of Israel. And he sent young men of the people of Israel who offered burnt offerings and sacrificed peace offerings of oxen to the Lord. And Moses took half of the blood and put it in basins, and half of the blood he threw against the altar. Then he took the book of the covenant and read it in the hearing of the people. And they said, "All that the Lord has spoken, we will do, and we will be obedient." And Moses took the blood and threw it on the people and said, "Behold, the blood of the covenant that the Lord has made with you in accordance with all these words." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, the cup of salvation I will raise, I will call on the name of the Lord. Altogether,
the cup of salvation I will raise, I will call on the name of the Lord.
How can I repay the Lord for all his goodness to me? The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the name of the Lord. Our response:
the cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the name of the Lord.
How precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful. Your servant am I, the son of your handmaid. You have loosened my bonds. Our response:
the cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the name of the Lord.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people. Our response:
the cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the name of the Lord. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brethren, when Christ appeared as a high priest of the good things that have come, then through the greater and more perfect tent, not made with hands, that is, not of this creation, he entered once for all into the holy places, not by means of the blood of goats and calves, but by means of his own blood, thus securing an eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkling of defiled persons with the ashes of a heifer sanctify for the purification of the flesh, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from dead works to serve the living God? Therefore, he is the mediator of a new covenant, so that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance, since a death has occurred that redeems them from the transgressions committed under the first covenant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly rise.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing his praise, sing his praise. Sing hallelujah to the Lord.
I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing his praise, sing his praise. Sing hallelujah to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, the disciples said to Jesus, "Where do you want us to go and make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?" So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, furnished and ready. Make preparation for us there." So the disciples set out and went to the city and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, down the ages there were several Eucharistic miracles. And God allows these miracles to prove that Jesus is really present in the Eucharist. One such example I would like to give is a Eucharistic miracle at Lanciano. Now, years ago, there was a monk who was afraid of losing his vocation. Once when he was celebrating Mass during the time of consecration, the bread turned into the flesh of Christ and the wine turned into the blood of Christ. Even after 1300 years, this flesh and blood of Christ can be seen and is exposed to the public. The flesh is stored in the monstrous and the blood is stored in the glass chalice. In the year 1971 and 81, a hospital laboratory wanted to test the flesh and blood of Christ, and they discovered that the flesh is myocardium, that is a muscular tissue of the heart. So we can say that it is heart of Christ, sacred heart of Christ. Now during the Mass, two miracles takes place during the time of the consecration. As I already mentioned, the ordinary bread turns into the flesh of Christ and the wine turns into the blood of Christ, which is known as transubstantiation. The second miracle, the substance, that is the bread and the wine, turns into the body and blood of Christ, but its appearance remains the same. The Eucharist is not just a symbol, it is a sacrament, the real presence of Christ, and it happens in every Mass by the ministry of the priest through the power of the Holy Spirit. We are not worthy to receive this Eucharist, and that is why in the beginning of the Mass we ask pardon and mercy, and even before receiving the Eucharist we express our unworthiness by saying, "Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed." My dear brothers, at Capernaum, Jesus had cured Peter's mother-in-law and he had cured many people. The same Jesus cures us or heals us in not only this Mass but every Mass. But more especially when during the time when we receive the Holy Communion, Jesus said, "He who eats my body and drinks my blood abides in me and I in him." That is John chapter 6 verse 56. At Cana, Jesus had changed the water into wine. And it is possible for him to change even this ordinary bread and wine into the flesh or his body and blood. What happens when we eat food? What are the effects of eating food? That is the physical food. When we have this material food, it assimilates in our body. That is, it unites in our body. What happens when we receive spiritual food? We unite ourselves in Christ. Christ said, "He who eats my body and drinks my blood will have eternal life and I will raise him up on the last day." John chapter 6. Verse 54. Now, what is the difference between the material food and the spiritual food? The material food that we have gives us strength, that is physical strength. But when we have the spiritual food, it gives us spiritual strength to face temptation and also fight against evil. When we have this physical food, it prolongs our life. But when we have the spiritual food, it gives us eternal life. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this Eucharist that we have preserves us from mortal sin. when we have this Eucharist, it gives us spiritual strength, as I already mentioned. In the time of the baptism, no doubt our original sin is washed away, but still we have the tendency to sin, and that is known as concupiscence. But when we receive the Eucharist frequently, our inclination towards sin is decreased. And when we receive the Eucharist, we become living tabernacle. You must have seen the host kept in the tabernacle. So we become living tabernacle, and people can see Christ in us. And that is why we need to reach out to others, especially those who are in need. Now especially we know that there are so many people who are suffering from various ailments, especially due to this pandemic. Can we reach out to them? Even in a small work, a small help can make a big difference. So we need to reach out and follow the footsteps of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, when animals and plants are sacrificed, then only provides nourishment to our body. For example, when you are preparing a vegetable, the plant has to be first uprooted. It is then subjected to knife and then is cooked in fire. Then only it provides us with nourishment. So also with animals. Animals are slaughtered, blood is shed and then cooked into fire, and then only it provides us with nourishment. What about Jesus Christ? He has sacrificed his life for us. His body and blood in the form of the communion provides us with spiritual nourishment. And that is why we need to take the Eucharist seriously. Very often we take it for granted. When we receive this Eucharist, we need to thank God for coming into our heart. And we also need to thank Him for giving us the gift of life. There are so many people who are suffering. We need to thank Him. And let us do the same. Let us pray that we may always follow the footsteps of the Lord, and most important, reach out to others. As Jesus said, not all those who say, "Lord, Lord," will enter the kingdom of heaven. So both prayers and actions are important. Only saying prayer will not help. Let us reach out to others and let us receive a blessing from God. And one day we will surely enter into the eternal kingdom that He has prepared for us. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As we come to our Heavenly Father on the feast of the body and blood of Christ, let us offer up the prayers of the Church and our own prayers, knowing that He always listens to us. Our response is, God of abundance, hear our prayer. Please repeat. God of abundance, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the Church, that they may help to instill in the faithful a love for the Eucharist, through which the body and blood of Christ is shared by all who partake in it. We pray to the Lord.
God of abundance, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that through their tireless and sincere service, people all over may live in security and have justice rendered to them equally. We pray to the Lord.
God of abundance, hear our prayer.
For all those who do not believe in the power of the Eucharist, that their faith might be strengthened and that they may have a personal encounter with Christ through this great sacrament. We pray to the Lord.
God of abundance, hear our prayer.
For individuals and families affected by the pandemic, especially those who have lost their loved ones, that they may be consoled and trust in God's plan of love for all his children. We pray to the Lord.
God of abundance, hear our prayer.
For all of us, devotees of Saint Anthony, that we may emulate the love and devotion Saint Anthony had for the Eucharist and encourage others to do likewise. We pray to the Lord.
God of abundance, hear our prayer.
For our personal needs, which we lift up in silence. We pray to the Lord.
God of abundance, hear our prayer. God our Father, thank you for your Son Jesus. Forgive us the great gift of the Eucharist and for listening to the prayers we have made through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus, you're the one I love. You're the one I know. You're the one who makes me strong, Spirit in my soul. From the clouds of yesterday, through the night of pain, teach me, Lord, to know your way, know it once again. Breathless and broken for us all, symbol of your love, from the grain so
pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Oswald our Bishop, his assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Let us make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious blood, body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our preacher for today was Father Desmond Fernandez. Father Desmond was ordained a priest in the year 2012 at Our Lady of Remedy Church, Poinsur. Father Desmond was very active with the various cells and associations. During the lockdown, he organized many virtual programs, both for the parishioners and at the deanery level. From 1st June, Father Desmond is transferred as assistant priest at Our Lady of Health Church, Sahar. We wish him all the best in his new assignment. Thank you, Father Desmond, for accepting our invitation to preach at our parish Novenas. Notices. Sunday, 6 June 2021. Friday, 11 June is the solemnity of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. The Antonian Youth Group E-Fiesta from 10th to 13th June. Sunday, 13 June is a parish feast in honor of Saint Anthony. The feast mass in Marathi and English will be online. The community welfare fund collection last month mounted to ₹2,47,620. Disbursement during the same month were ₹2,77,392. We thank you for your generosity.
Novena in honor of Saint Anthony. The miraculous responsory. If you seek for miracles, death, error, all calamities, the leprosy and demons fly, and health succeeds infirmities.
The sea obeys and fetters break, and lifeless limbs thou dost restore, while treasures lost are found again, when young and old thine aid implore.
All dangers vanish at thy prayer, the direst need doth quickly flee. Let those who know thy power proclaim, let Padwans say these are of thee.
The sea obeys and fetters break, and lifeless limbs thou dost restore, while treasures lost are found again, when young and old thy aid implore.
To the Father, Son, all glory be, and Holy Ghost eternally.
The sea obeys and fetters break, and lifeless limbs thou dost restore, while treasures lost are found again, when young and old thy aid implore.
Pray for us, Blessed Anthony,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. O God, let the votive commemoration of Blessed Anthony, thy confessor and doctor, be a source of joy to the faithful, that they may always be fortified with spiritual assistance and may deserve to possess eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A most efficacious prayer to Saint Anthony. O holy Saint Anthony, the gentleness and kindness of all the saints, your burning love of God, your exalted virtues, and your great charity towards your fellow creatures, made you worthy when on earth to possess miraculous powers, such as were given to no other saints. Miracles waited on your word, and that word you were ever ready to speak at the request of those in trouble. The anxious prayer of bitter trial was never addressed to you in vain. To the sick you gave back health, you restored what was lost. The sorrow-stricken were the objects of your tender compassion. Even the dead you raised to life when the wounded heart cried out to you from the depth of its anguish. When on earth nothing was impossible to you except not to have compassion on those in distress and sorrow. Encouraged by this thought and convinced of the efficacy of your intercession, I kneel before your holy image and full of confidence, I implore of you to obtain. Kindly name your intention. Altogether, the answer to this prayer may require a miracle. Even so, are you not a saint of miracles, who when on earth had but to speak, and the mightiest wonders were wrought? O gentle and loving Saint Anthony, you whose heart was ever full of human sympathy, whisper my prayers into the ears of infant Jesus, who loved to linger in your arms. One word from you, and my prayers will be granted. Oh, speak that word, and the gratitude of my heart will ever be yours. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Third day, anyone who loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Let us pray that through the intercession of Saint Anthony, we may not be blinded by excessive love of our dear ones as not to heed the call of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear thy people, have mercy on us.
That through the intercession of Saint Anthony, we may obtain the wisdom and strength to love Christ more than our relatives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear thy people, have mercy on us.
That through the intercession of Saint Anthony, we assist the priestly or religious vocation in others to mature. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear thy people, have mercy on us.
That through the intercession of Saint Anthony, those who have answered the call may persevere. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear thy people, have mercy on us.
Prayer. O God, Saint Anthony generously responded to your call. Grant to those to do likewise, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
We now pray for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic. We pray that the vaccine be available for all our people, even the poor and those in rural areas. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Bhagivanta Santa Toni, Yeshu Pasi Manga Tumi, Daya Tumi Kara Auriyama Papi Awarti. Jai Jai Kar Karu Abhi, Sada Tum Che Navani, Nai Sar Nar Kawa Ami Morte Tum Che Abari. Lam Lam Dao Che Alau Ami, Magni Kar Tau Wali Wali, Ai kun ge un tumi sagli manga Yeshu che mire. Jai jai kar karu ami, sada tum che navani, nai visar nar kawa ami moti tum che abari. Jai jai kar karu ami, sada tum che navani, nai sar nar kawa ami morte tum che abari.